Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lena if you guys are new. If you have not subscribed already, I would absolutely love if you did. I make fashion, beauty, and lifestyle videos on this channel and I would love for you guys to join the family. If you guys like modest fashion tips videos, please give this video a thumbs up so I know to make more of them. And today's video is going to be all about all the essentials that you need in your closet to create a modest wardrobe. I've gotten some requests recently to do a modest capsule wardrobe. What are the essentials in my wardrobe that I need? This video is for those of you who maybe want to start dressing more modestly but don't know which pieces in your wardrobe you might be missing. So I hope that you guys enjoy this video. I'm gonna give you guys some tips first and then I'll get into my essentials. So let's get started. I have three different tips for you guys to keep in mind when choosing items for your wardrobe. So number one is, what is your aesthetic? What is your style? This took me so long to figure out, you guys. If you followed me back when I first started my Instagram and my blog, wow, it was a completely different Lena. I know some of you guys followed me back then. Maybe I'll insert a picture of like one of my outfits. Wow, it took me a long time to figure out what I felt comfortable in, and it took a lot of experimentation. So if you guys don't know what your style is, believe me, it takes people a long time sometimes, like it did for me. So things that help is going to Pinterest, pinning different items, finding similarities in the pictures that you like, finding content creators that have a similar vibe to you, and really just trying to find your personal style, because my personal style may not be yours. So some of these pieces that I'm going to show you guys may not work for your wardrobe, so you just really need to take them with a grain of salt. The second thing I want you guys to consider is what colors actually suit your skin tone. This is so important when choosing items for your wardrobe, especially like those classic everyday items. You really want them to be super flattering. I have a video all about how to choose colors that suit your skin tone and how to figure out what colors work best for you. It's a video I think I did maybe like a year ago or more, but it still has some really, really, really good relevant information and will be super helpful for you guys. In my humble opinion, I just feel like all the building block essential pieces in your wardrobe should definitely be in neutral colors. That way you can mix and match them with so many different items in your wardrobe. You can create so many different looks. The last thing I want you guys to consider is your lifestyle. You guys, this is so important. If you are a student, if you work from home, you are not gonna wanna fill your closet with a bunch of like corporate like blazers and suits and, you know, very professional pieces, because you're never gonna wear those. Really consider what you're actually gonna wear for your lifestyle. Now let's get into the 9 essential items I think every girl needs in a modest wardrobe. Essential number one is a white blouse or a white top. Depending on your aesthetic, it could be an elegant blouse like this, it could be a white t-shirt, it could be something with a lot of ruffles, but it's just something that will literally go with every single outfit. It's the perfect base to the rest of your wardrobe because it will go with all your bottoms. I also want to mention blouses like this. This is a sleeveless high neck blouse that is an essential for me during the warmer months. You do not want to add extra layers when you do not have to, when it is hot outside, and layering like a long sleeve shirt underneath a duster or something is just so unnecessary. So I wanted to mention something like this. I got this from Banana Republic, but I will try to find similar and link them down below. Next is a pair of really good flattering jeans that are still modest. So there are so many different modest cuts nowadays that are in style. I feel like literally every single denim style is in right now. So that's amazing. There's wide leg, there's boyfriend, there's straight leg, there's the mom jean. There are so many options for modest jeans out there. I found some really good ones recently from H&M that are like a mom jean. I'm actually wearing them right now. They're high-waisted and they're like straight leg. They're awesome. I will link those down below. In my wardrobe, it's essential to have blue, black, and white denim, just because I just interchange those all the time and they're such essentials for me. So just depending on what you like and what your style is, I just think that a really good pair of denim is an absolute essential. My next essential is tapered trousers in neutral colors. You guys, I love this style of pant for a modest wardrobe. They're the style of pant that is a little bit looser around the bottom area and tapers in towards the ankle. And they can be dressed up or down. You can wear them so many different ways. They would be great to wear to work. They would be great to wear with sneakers and like a t-shirt. You can get it in camel, tan, black, gray, like any of those neutral colors, and just will work so well. I love the paper bag waist pants with the little bow. Right now, I'm just like super obsessed with that style, but I think tapered trousers are a definite must for me. My next modest essential is a long line blazer. This is such a necessity in my wardrobe. You can get them in so many different neutral colors. If black is your vibe, a black blazer is super classic. You can dress these up or down. You can wear them with sneakers. You can wear them with heels. When you're looking for modest blazers that cover up the backside, I always search for blazer dresses, long line blazers, boyfriend blazers, or oversized blazers. So when you're searching for those, use those keywords and you will hopefully find more modest styles. My next modest essential is a lightweight trench coat or a duster jacket. Dusters are usually a little bit more lightweight, so they're good for those warmer months. They just add a really nice layer of modesty that literally I get use of all year round. Trench usually is gonna be a little bit thicker, more of like an actual jacket. During like the transitional months, like during spring and during fall, they are such classic pieces to have in your wardrobe. So I would highly recommend a trench coat and a duster jacket. I kind of put those in the same category because they kind of are similar. I feel like I am constantly talking about these, but they are such necessities in my wardrobe. These are lightweight layering t-shirts that you can wear under your clothes to keep things from being see-through, to keep things from showing your skin. If you have cutouts in your clothes, keyhole backs, lace like I'm wearing today, just anything that's gonna show your skin, these are absolute necessities. Next modest layering essential are leggings. So I have white and black that I wear all the time. The white is really good if you have white sheer pants and you need to keep everything covered. And then I wear the black just with anything. Dresses that I feel like I just want to make sure my legs are covered if the wind blows or something. These are from ASOS and these are from Mango, but I will link some similar down below. Next essential is a basic neutral long skirt. This is actually a satin midi skirt that I got from Topshop. One way that I get my midi skirts to be long enough for me is I order them in the tall version. Topshop does this. If you guys haven't seen my modest fashion hacks video, there's a lot more where those came from, so I'll link that for you guys up there. I find myself reaching for this satin midi skirt a lot because if I have like a nice dinner that I'm going to, or if I have just like an event at someone's house that I'm going to, any kind of like little party I'm going to, I always reach for this. It's something you can dress up or down. You could wear this with a t-shirt and sneakers and it'd be really cute, or you can wear it with heels and a blazer and it looks super super chic. So that's why I think this is an absolute essential. This last item is something I really debated putting in here or not, but I really do think this is a necessity in my wardrobe, and I think that a lot of you guys would get inspiration and think that this was a necessity as well. So I'm gonna put this in the dresses slash jumpsuits category. If you are a dress kind of girl and wear a dress on a daily basis, I definitely think you need a basic neutral dress that you can dress up or down, that you can wear on a daily basis, or you can wear with heels and go to an event. I really don't wear dresses on a daily basis, but a jumpsuit is something I find myself reaching for all the time, even more than I actually realized. If I ever have like a special event and I don't know what to wear, if it's like kind of dressy but not really that dressy, I always reach for a jumpsuit because you can dress this up or down so many ways. You can wear it with sneakers, you can wear it with heels, you can wear it with a blazer over top, you can put a nice blouse underneath it and just kind of layer it up. This is actually one from Banana Republic that is fully lined, non-sheer. It's amazing. If they still have it, I will link it, but if it's not, I will link similar. Let me know what you guys think. I personally think a like neutral jumpsuit is something that you can wear so many different ways and is a real classic in my wardrobe. Give this video a thumbs up if you want more modest fashion tips videos. I love you guys so, so much, and I will see y'all in my next one. Bye.